Hello students, today we'll study accounting equations. First of all, it is very important to understand meaning of equation. Mathematically, an equation means when left hand side is equal to right hand side. In accounting equation means assets equal to capital plus liabilities. Why assets are equal to the sum of capital and liability? The reason is assets are the economic resources which are being held by a business for its smooth operation, and on these assets there are certain claim means who has invested money in buying these assets for the business. If these assets are being bought by the money of owner, by the proprietor, then it is capital. And if that money has been borrowed from outsiders, that means third parties other than who belongs to a business, then that term is liability. So assets carry claim, either it is internal liability termed as capital, or it carry external debts, that is liabilities. Accounting equation is also known as balance sheet equation. Balance sheet is a sheet which shows assets and liabilities of a business. All assets are economic resources, and these assets are either bought by the owner from his own money or they are being borrowed. It could be from bank overdraft, creditors, bills payable, bank loan, or outstanding expenses. There are certain expenses, might be you have bought some material, or there are certain amount due to your employees as salary and that amount has yet to be paid. So whatever assets a business is carrying, it might have certain claims, and these claims are either made by the owner himself in the form of capital or made by outsiders in the form of liabilities. Now we will do certain transactions. For a better understanding of this concept, before doing it, it is very important to understand that a transaction may affect either both sides, left hand side as well as right hand side of an equation, or only one side of the equation. And on that one side, there will be both increase or decrease by equal amount. See, we know the equation is asset is equal to capital plus liability. If asset is increasing with the same amount, might be the capital is rising without any change in liabilities. Or if asset is falling with the same amount, there is fall in the value of capital. Liabilities are same, zero. If assets are rising, might be the capital is zero and liabilities are rising. Or assets are falling without any change in capital, but the liabilities are also falling with the same amount. It might also happen there is increase and decrease in assets only without any change on the right hand side. Also, without any change in asset, there could be increase and decrease in liabilities or in capital. So it could be either of the case. It depends upon the business transaction which has been undertaken. Starting with our first transaction, let's say a business has been started with cash rupees 1 lakh. What will be its impact on the capital, liability and asset of the business? We know the equation is asset is equal to capital plus liabilities. In asset, we know when the businessman is bringing cash into the business, then the cash of the business is rising. Also, the amount which is being invested by the owner in the business is known as capital. So it must affect capital as well as asset of the business. Now assets are affected in the form of cash. Cash will rise with amount of rupees 1 lakh. Capital will also increase with rupees 1 lakh without any change in liabilities. Coming to second case where goods are being purchased for cash. See, it's very, very, very simple. Being a layman also, you can answer. When a business buys goods, goods are rising in the business, whereas cash is falling. Now, what will be its impact? We know that the goods are rising, so the stock of the business will rise with the amount of rupees 50,000, whereas cash will fall with amount of rupees 50,000. We can see that there is increase and decrease on the same side, that is left hand side, without affecting the right hand side. Capital and liability will stand at zero. Now the next case is purchasing furniture for cash. When furniture is being purchased, obviously the cash will fall and the asset, that is furniture, will rise without any effect on capital and liabilities of the business. I hope these cases are clear. Moving ahead, our next case, sold goods for cash. When goods are being sold for cash, cash will rise with 40,000, whereas stock will fall with rupees 40,000 without affecting capital and liability. Sold land for cash. Now asset is being sold. Now cash will rise with rupees 1,50,000, whereas land will fall with the amount of rupees 1,50,000 without affecting capital and liabilities. Purchase goods on credit rupees 15,000. Now goods are being purchased on credit. Jab goods credit par khareedenge to supplier kya ban jayega? Creditor ban jayega. Third party hai. He does not belong to your business. He's an outsider. So liability is being created. Stock increase hoga 15,000 se aur creditors bhi increase honge 15,000 se. Here liability is being created as goods are being purchased on credit. Moving ahead, income receive hui hai. Income receive hogi. It's quite obvious that cash of the business will rise. But income ka effect kahan aayega? It will increase owner's equity. Capital will rise with rupees 2,000 without affecting liabilities. Yani jab bhi income or expense ka treatment hoga, it will be done through capital of the owner. Next, expenses pay kiye 1500 ke. What will be its impact? Obviously, when you will pay expenses, cash will fall. As it is an expense, it will also decrease capital of the owner. Depreciation on furniture. What is depreciation? Depreciation is fall in the value of fixed asset due to normal wear and tear, a flux of time, or even obsolescence. Jab koi cheez obsolete ho jati hai, outdated ho jati hai. So the value of an asset may fall. This fall is a loss, and loss are being compensated from capital only, and it will also decrease the value of furniture by 500. Capital will also fall by rupees 500 without affecting liabilities. Amount drawn for personal use. What is it known as? Amount drawn for personal use is drawings, and drawings decreases the capital of the owner. Amount draw hoga, to business ki cash fall karegi. Aur saath hi saath owner ki capital bhi fall karegi. It's not always that a businessman withdrew cash from a business. It might also happen that he is withdrawing some goods. Stationery shop ka agar owner hai, to wo apne bete ke liye stationery nikal sakta hai business mein se. So that is drawing. What will be its impact? Stock of the business will fall. Also, the capital of the business will decrease without affecting liabilities. Moving to our next slide. Received cash from debtors rupees 19,500 in full settlement of his amount of rupees 20,000. Yani hame debtor se amount lena tha 20,000. Par humne full settlement mein usse kitna receive kiya hai? Humne full settlement mein usse receive kiya 19,500. Yani ab settlement ho gayi. Pure humare dues clear ho gaye hain. It is a loss for a business. अमाउंट लेना था 20,000 कस्टमर से, पर लिया 19,500. तो कैश कितना आया हमारे पास बिजनेस में? 19,500. जबकि बिजनेस की एसेट, दैट इज डेटर, डिक्रीज्ड बाय 20,000. सो वी कैन सी दिस साइड वी आर हैविंग अ नेगेटिव बैलेंस ऑफ रुपीज 500, विच इज ड्यू टू डिस्काउंट अलाउड. इट इज अ लॉस फॉर अ बिजनेस. सो दिस लॉस ऑफ 500 will be subtracted from capital of the owner. I hope this case is clear. Next case is sold goods costing 12,000. Goods ki cost hai 12,000. Par in goods ko humne sell kar diya 15,000 ka. Aap bataiye, agar 12,000 amount ke goods ko hum 15,000 ka bechenge, to business ko profit hoga ya loss? It is very, very clear from this transaction that the business is earning profit. Aur profit kisko increase karta hai business ki? Capital. Owner ki capital ko. So, when we will sell goods, stock will fall with the amount of rupees 12,000. Always remember, jab sale karenge goods ki, to stock mein se cost minus hogi. And what is the cost? Cost is 12,000. And these goods are being sold on credit. That means the business is going to have debtors. Business ke kya honge? Debtors. पर डेटर कितने अमाउंट के होंगे 15,000 के बिकॉज जो हमारा प्राइस सेट हुआ है अपने कस्टमर के साथ दैट इज 15,000 वी अर्न द प्रॉफिट ऑफ रुपीज 3,000 विच विल इंक्रीज द कैपिटल ऑफ द ओनर लायबिलिटी विल नॉट चेंज इट कैन ऑल्सो हैपन दैट द कॉस्ट ऑफ द गुड इज मोर एंड द सेलिंग प्राइस इज लेस इन दैट केस वी आर इंक्रिंग अ लॉस ऑफ रुपीज 500 This loss will decrease the capital of the owner. As I just stated, stock mein se hum kya minus karenge sale ke time? Cost. So, yani kitna subtract hoga amount? 7,000. Again, it is on credit. Par ab aapke debtor kitne mein settle hue hain? 6,500 mein. Aapne deal done kiya 6,500 mein. You can see on the left hand side, we are having a negative balance of 500. It is because of loss. Loss on sale of goods that will be subtracted from capital. I hope these cases are clear. Moving ahead, sold goods on credit. What if goods are sold on credit? Kuch nahi likha, cost price kya hai? Aapka aur selling price given hai 4,000. To hum डायरेक्टली इसी अमाउंट के साथ डील करेंगे स्टॉक विल डिक्रीज बाय 4,000 और अगर हम क्रेडिट पर बेच रहे हैं तो डेटर्स विल राइज बाय 4,000 विदाउट अफेक्टिंग कैपिटल एंड लाइबिलिटी नाउ अगेन सोल्ड गुड्स कॉस्टिंग 12,000 फॉर रुपीज 15,000 अगर हम इसको रिकैपिचुलेट करें स्टॉक डिक्रीज होगा कॉस्ट से 12,000 कैश इंक्रीज हो रही है 15,000 से सी इट इज नॉट ऑन क्रेडिट नाउ यू आर सेलिंग गुड्स ऑन कैश बेसिस रिकैपिचुलेट करेंगे क्या कि प्रॉफिट हो रहा है या लॉस हो रहा है कंपैरिजन में वी आर अर्निंग अमाउंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट ऑफ रुपीज 3,000 बट हियर द ट्रांजेक्शन हैज टेकन प्लेस ऑन कैश बेसिस कैपिटल इंक्रीज होगी 3,000 से विदाउट एनी चेंज इन लाइबिलिटीज वॉट इफ दीज गुड्स आर सोल्ड on cash basis but we are incurring a loss stock will decrease by 7,000 which is the cost cash I business ke paas 6,500 jabki capital mein we will show loss of 500 which will decrease owner's equity that is capital moving ahead started business with cash land plant it can also happen that in a business a businessman is bringing things in kind instead of bringing only cash he is also bringing some assets us case mein hamare paas cash bhi aaya land bhi aaya plant bhi aaya cash aaya 10,000 land aaya 1 lakh plant for 20,000 and total will be your capital liabilities are zero also in a business If you buy a running business and you start a business, you are having opening balance of cash, you have land, you have plant, and there are certain liabilities as well. So in that case, what will be the balance of capital? See, cash, land, plant, we have as asset. Cash 10,000, land 1 lakh, plant 20. Upar wale case mein hamari capital 1 lakh 30 thi. But is case mein hamari capital is 1 lakh 15. Because from our assets, we will subtract our liability of rupees 15,000 so as to calculate the amount of capital which stands at rupees 15,000. I hope this case is clear. Deposited into bank. What will happen when money will be deposited into bank? See, if money is deposited into bank, the cash balance will fall and the bank balance of the business will rise without affecting capital and liabilities. Next, accrued income. What is accrued income? Accrued income is due income, income which is yet to be received, but the businessman and the business have already provided their services. Now, this is an income for the business. It is a recognized amount. So, as the amount is not received in cash, so it will not affect the cash of the business. Accrued income will be a head which will be open under head assets amounting to rupees 200. As it is an income, earned amount hai, earned but not received hai. Earn ho gaya hai, isliye capital mein add hoga without affecting liabilities. Outstanding expense. जैसे इनकम ड्यू हुई है वैसे एक्सपेंस भी तो ड्यू हो सकता है. आपने किसी के पैसे देने हैं दिए नहीं हैं. सो दिस अमाउंट इज योर लाइबिलिटी. यू हैव टू पे दिस अमाउंट. दिस अमाउंट इज येट टू बी पेड. इट हैज नॉट डिक्रीज्ड योर कैश. तो इसका एसेट साइड तो कोई इफेक्ट नहीं आएगा. बट दिस एक्सपेंस हैज बीन इनकर्ड. यू हैव ऑलरेडी अवेल्ड द सर्विसेज फॉर योर बिजनेस. सो दिस विल डिक्रीज योर कैपिटल. And outstanding expense will increase your liabilities. I hope this case is clear. Unaccrued income, that means the income that you have not earned for your business, but you have received in advance. It is not your income. It is your liability. This amount is your liability because unless and until you will not provide the services, you cannot have a right on this amount. So this amount has been received in cash. So it will increase your cash of the business, but it is a liability. So we'll open a head under head liabilities known as unaccrued income amounting to rupees 200. Prepaid expenses. Our expenses paid in advance. अब आपने किसी खर्चे की पेमेंट पहले से कर दी. It's quite obvious that your cash is falling. आपके बिजनेस की कैश फॉल कर रही है. But अभी क्योंकि आपने इन expenses जो पे किए इनके लिए services avail नहीं किए. This is your asset. So prepaid expense head will be opened under head assets and the amount will increase by rupees 500 without affecting capital and liability. I hope this case is clear. Ke prepaid expense, let us recapitulate it once. Let us start with prepaid expense. Prepaid expenses are assets because aapne iske liye payment pehle se kar di hai par abhi services avail nahi ki hai. So this is your amount lying with someone else. So this is your asset, whereas unaccrued income is advance received for income. Unaccrued income, जैसे आपने advance में expenses को pay किया, वैसे आपने advance में income receive की. क्योंकि अभी आपने services render नहीं किए हैं, so it is your liability. It will be shown under the head liability. Similarly, due का case भी discuss कर लेते हैं. Outstanding expenses. Outstanding expenses वो expenses हैं जिनकी payment आपको करनी है but this amount you have not paid yet. However, you have already availed the services. So this is your liability. So it will be shown under the head liabilities. Similarly, accrued income. Accrued income is due income which is yet to be received but you have already given the services. आउटस्टैंडिंग एक्सपेंस में आपने ऑलरेडी सर्विसेज अवेल कर ली थी. अक्रूड इनकम में आपने ऑलरेडी सर्विसेज रेंडर कर दी हैं बट आपका अमाउंट अभी आपको नहीं मिला है. दिस इज योर एसेट. आई होप नाउ द केसेस आर क्लियर. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. स्टे कनेक्टेड एंड डू सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल.